We're here in West Milford, New Jersey to pursue a Bigfoot encounter. We're gonna meet up with the individual and head out to Clinton Road to see what we can find.
All right, hi, thanks for meeting us.
Oh, it's great to be here. I'm ready to bring Bigfoot to justice. Lady.
Obviously, you've had a personal encounter with Bigfoot, so can you, like, walk us through that?
Ha! You bet I can tell you that tale. So imagine, if you will, I'm in my backyard, and I have firewood in my hand, and I see across the yard there's some rustling. There's some rustling in the branches right across the creek. And so I got really nervous. I dropped the wood on my foot, and I was like, oh! And then I look up, and there was eyes, like big old eyes, like devil eyes. They were staring at me through the tree branches. They were staring through me. They were staring through my soul. I panicked. I thought I was going to die. I've never seen anything like it.
You know, to be honest, I really think that the guy has some valid points to his, you know, what we're discussing over there about this Bigfoot. But, I don't know.
This is where our story came from over here.
I actually saw some, or heard about sightings. I read about it online, that there's sightings around Joseph's Spaghetti Shack.
Well, I mean, from the moment he started talking, I mean, everything about the bushes and the red eyes glowing from across the creek, I mean.
That's great.
The creek.
So here we are. We're actually on Clinton Road now. We're about a minute from our location for the night, and I'm excited. I mean, it's just about sunset now, so we're gonna have some good time to find some Squatch. Let's see what they think.
New experience besides finding Squatch is I've actually never been in a car before. So, what was that? Whoa!
Sorry, there's a.
I'm still really skeptical about this whole thing.
I'm sitting next to the most beautiful girl in the world.
I'm cold! Stop complaining! It's a
We're gonna make our way in and take a look at the creek that we passed over the ghost ranch around. We're gonna take a look where the sighting was last.
We're out here. We're just gonna give a quick little call to Bobo and the group and see how they are, how they're doing.
I'm so cold. I'm so frustrated.
Did you hear that?
I heard nothing. I heard nothing. I'm cold and I'm frustrated still.
Did you hear that call?
That's exactly what I heard when I had my wood.
You guys didn't hear that call, did you? No, I didn't do anything.
I gotta say, I'm really scared actually. I'm actually really nervous. I've had nightmares about this ever since it's happened. It's all flooding back to me. I don't want to be here.
This proof, like, you can take it out, you can crumble it up and throw it, it's proof. It's hand, hard proof.
New Jersey was a big surprise to me. You know, I really held up my hopes and I think they paid off tonight.
I've had countless interactions. Actually, no, that's a lie. I think it's just a complete waste of time, like it has been for the last 20 years.
I just heard the Squatch call and it's just totally real. Like, this is happening. This is legit. This is madness. We got whatever that chance.
And so, the Finding Bigfoot crew concludes another long, hard day at work. Only this time they go home knowing that Bigfoot is indeed real. Everyone is satisfied except for Renee, who will go home alone in her bedroom apartment in Lower Murderdale. Tune in next week to see how the group fares when Bobo decides to link up with Bear Grylls.
My mom doesn't even know where I am.